Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Learn Commerce with Namita. I am Namita Mane. In today's video, let us discuss investment institutions in India. So today we are going to talk about UTI. UTI stands for Unit Trust of India. It is one of the investment institution of our country. This is a logo of UTI. So UTI basically is concerned with mutual fund. So let's talk about UTI in detail. UTI stands for Unit Trust of India. Unit Trust of India was first set up on 1st February 1964. So UTI was established in the year 1964 under the UTI Act, Unit Trust of India Act 1963 by the Government of India. UTI began its operation legally. It started working in the month July 1964. It was established, it was set up in the year 1964, 1st February 1964, under the Act of UTI Act 1963 by the Government of India. And it started legally its operation in the month July 1964. And it is a statutory public sector investment institution having the main objective to encourage and mobilize the saving of the community. So it is a statutory means by law, okay? And it is a UTI is what? A public sector investment institution. UTI is public sector investment institution, and the main objective is to encourage, mobilize the savings of community means of the public. The headquarter is located in Mumbai, Maharashtra. Next, unit trust is a investment plan. Unit trust is a investment plan where the funds are pulled together and then invested. So unit trust is what? A investment plan where all the funds are collected together and then they are invested. Like mutual funds, okay? So the funds that has been pulled is later is unitized, and the investors is known as a unit holder. He or she holds a certain number of units, and on the other hand, the second party, which is the manager, and that manager is responsible for the daily running of the trust and for investing the fund. So this is unit trust. Next, we'll see the objective of UTI, Unit Trust of India. So the primary objective of UTI is to promote and pull the small savings from the lower and middle class income person, those who cannot have a direct access to stock exchange. So the people who do not have direct access to stock exchange, so UTI is one of the option where the smaller as well middle class income people can invest their savings. It gives them the opportunity to share the benefit. And next objective is to provide a secured return on investment. These are the objectives of UTI. Next, we'll see the organization and management of UTI. How UTI was formed and the management structure of UTI. So UTI was established with an initial capital of rupees 5 crore, and this 5 crore was contributed by Reserve Bank of India, LIC, Life Insurance Corporation, SBI, State Bank of India and its subsidiary, and some scheduled banks and financial institution. So UTI was established with the initial capital of 5 crore, and this 5 crore was contributed by RBI, LIC, SBI, subsidiaries, SBI and its subsidiaries, scheduled banks and financial institution. And this initial capital of 5 crore was divided into 1000 certificates of 50,000 each. Next, the management of UTI. UTI is managed by a board of trustee. It is managed by whom? It is managed by board of trustee. It consists a chairman. The board of trustee consists a chairman. Then four members which are nominated by Reserve Bank of India. One member is nominated by LIC. One member is nominated by State Bank of India. And other two members are elected by contributing institutions. So this is the management of UTI, means Board of Trustee. In Board of Trustee, there is chairman, four members which are nominated by Reserve Bank of India. One member is nominated by LIC. And one member is nominated by SBI. And more two members are elected by contributing institution. Next, we'll move to the functions of UTI. So the functions of UTI is, it encourage the saving of lower and middle class people. It tries to convert the small saving into industrial finance. It also provides liquidity to units. Then it accepts discount, purchase or sell, bill of exchange, warehouse receipt, documents of title to goods, etc. It also provides merchant banking and investment advisory to service to investors. Then it provides leasing and hire purchase business. Next, it also formulates a unit scheme or insurance plan in association with GIC. So these are the functions of UTI. Let's move to the schemes of UTI. These are some schemes of UTI. There are many schemes. I have selected few schemes like unit scheme 1964, unit link insurance plan 1971, children gift growth fund unit scheme 1986, Rajya Lakshmi unit scheme 1992, senior citizen unit plan 1993, means this plan was set up in the year 1993, monthly income unit scheme, UTI growth sector funds, then money market mutual fund. So these are some few schemes of UTI. Okay, so I hope you have understood Investment Institutions of India, UTI. Today in this video we have covered about UTI, the structure, management, functions, objectives of UTI. I hope you have understood this session. Thank you very much. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, like and share the video, and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the latest notification.